your mind's eye, I'm going to tell you a story. And today, I'm going to tell you about how I met Steve McQueen, an iconic, legendary actor. If you don't know who Steve McQueen is, look him up. He's in most of the 60s and 70s. He was So, 1978, I graduated high school, and I went to Texas, and I went to California, and I landed a job at J&J Crop Dusters. That was a cool job, and I wasn't a pilot, but that's great. I drove the truck full of water, chemicals, fuel, and everything you needed. So I was on the runway on Saturday. I was at the shop using their tools to fix an early 70 model Pinto. Remember the little Pinto, ugly green? Yeah, that's the one. So I'm under the hood and I'm turning wrenches and I'm working on Saturday. And I hear this vroom. I mean, loud vroom. So I come out from underneath the hood and I'm looking around and I see this bright yellow, beautiful biplane come surfing around. And it came in off over the landing strip. And as it come in, it turned sideways. And they do this so that they can see and line up on the runway. And then right before he lands, he turns. And it was impressive. So he lands and he pulls some taxis on up to the office and the shop is. And he gets out and he says, "Hello." I told him, "Hey, what can I do for you?" And he said, "I need some fuel." So I pointed over to the office. From boss man's inside there. And he went inside the office. And of course my boss, Jack Walker, he comes out and he's giving me the sign, "Go ahead and put some fuel in there." So I did. I went and got the truck, pulled it around, pulled it up to this pretty yellow high plane, and started fueling it up. Jack, the boss, comes out and he says, "And clean the windows really good too." So he goes, "You know who that was, right?" "No." He said, "That's Steve McQueen." I didn't get it. He had a full beard. He had the aviation sunglasses and a bandana wrapped around his head, and no, I didn't see it, I didn't recognize it. I'm thinking about it, so I get done, I clean the windows, and I pull the truck, and I pull the truck back around, and put the truck back where it goes, going back up to the shop, and he comes out and thanks me for fueling his plane. No problem. But when I saw him, it clicked. You could tell. And it was Steve McQueen. So he got back in his plane and he cranked it up and they're loud. The big old motor was loud. And he took off. Flew off in the sunset. And so pretty much nowadays, if I see one of his movies, I always, "Hey, I met Steve McQueen." It's not like I really met him, but interacted with him. So did